cases have you know, worked well. But I also want to share my own views. I've been here about 20 years now. And, so I think there are a few constraints. I'm going to give four issues where I think we need to grapple more with these issues and do better at confronting the fact that our perspective on them need to change. I think this institution at the core is still very much an institution who believes in quantitative data. We have this culture, and I think it's important, but the problems we have with quantitative data when we look at the field like empowerment and accountability is that it's going to be incredibly difficult to stop there. One of the issues that I think we overlook because we look at quantitative is the issues of perceptions. You put in your world things, we are impunity, injustice. No, these sometimes are actually, quote unquote, just perceptions, but they matter, right? And we are looking at supporting development, we're looking at outcomes, outcome for the entire country. But maybe when we look at this outcome for entire countries, if we were disaggregating them by self-identified groups in this country, the story would be different. And how do we get there? So I think we need to shift in cultures to acknowledge the power of this rigorous qualitative data. The second point, and is linked to that, is the local knowledge. Even more in fragile states, I think everywhere, you rarely have you might have one set of underlying norms you have in one country, but it's going to vary at the local level, and it's difficult, especially in some FCV. Our staff are actually confined in their office in like a green zone or something, no? And they have to address issues that are going to be very variable and fluid in the context where they operate. And how do we get this knowledge? And I think the local dynamics, now, we really always need help from people from this country. There are staff in the country office of the bank, but they also come with their own baggage. And it is extraordinarily difficult when you are trying to work immediately at scale and in a short time and prepare a project that's going to have a linear framework to embed these issues in this. So even starting with, do we know what people care about? We want to work on accountability. We tend to say, I'm doing an education project. I would want people to fight for their education right. Well, it's possible that where you are operating, what people care more about, or where they have structure that exists about, it would be about land titling, no? So, third point on the interlocutors, and that's I think, by the way we are structured and the scale at which we operate, we are much more comfortable working with formal interlocutors. And in a lot of places, informal institutions and the way they interact is what's going to really matter. And we find sometimes they are much more legitimate in their own realm that the structure and the formal partners we interact with. So that's another constraint for us. And I think that especially in FCV, where there is this reconfiguration of social and political power, we have to engage with groups that don't necessarily, that we don't feel comfortable engaging with. And it's not that we don't do it ever, and there is a very interesting research that has been done and recently published by the bank on social service delivery in South Asia, where they are investigating, the role of the warlord, the armed groups, etc. But it's still very complicated. And finally, the last point is, this program is all about empowerment and accountability, and it's social and political accountability. And the World Bank continues to feel very constrained in engaging with the politics. And we have now, we just published a World Development Report on power and politics. So at least in the thinking, we've made a lot of progress. We're trying to be more open on this, the fact that it exists and it has to be studied and understood. But in terms of action, there are some things, well, for instance, elections, right? We don't engage with elections and we can't, right? But if you look at accountability and you don't look at the power of elections, and your example in Pakistan was right there, I mean, that's sort of constraint. So I think that one of the things that some teams do is indeed analyzing these parts. But I see also a lot of self-censorship, even in our analytical products. Some of our systemic country diagnoses have sections looking at what is the status, quote-unquote, of citizen engagement in this country. And you read the first draft and there is nothing about political parties, elections. And that's really something that, I mean, we know it's part of it, right? But how do we engage more? Is it within our mandate? I stop there. Thank you very much.
Great. Thank you very much.